Hi folks, this is David Kwan here, and the topic of this video is of course a pretty fraught one. There's been a lot of emotions surrounding this, you know, and in New York City it's a big thing. I think this week, especially as you know, I'm in New York City and I'm a social work student in NYU, and a lot of my colleagues, a lot of the students there are kind of feeling, especially social work students, are just kind of, there's a lot of outrage, there's a lot of disappointment, there's also a lot of inspiration, a lot of hope, a lot of movement going around. So that's kind of my little bubble that I'm in, that I see a lot of. And this week I didn't go do any protests or do any marches or do any sit-ins. I wanted to, but it kind of didn't end up happening. For me, in some ways, I think it's partly my fault too. I could have, in some ways, on Thursday, I probably could have, but I had to meet with someone to kind of talk about the project that she's doing. But yeah, it's a big thing, I think, and it's just for me, you know, I do feel a lot of the outrage, a lot of the disappointment, and I guess it feels like there was a lot of feeling around here. It's like, in New York City, you know, in New York, this, and we have video evidence, but still, like, it's not even like I talked about Ferguson before, but Darren Wilson, like, the matter that the grand jury decided is whether he should be tried or not. It's not a question of whether he's guilty or not. It's whether somebody should be, somebody in a police officer should be tried for an action, whatever charge that action might be, that ended up with a black person dead, you know, for between interaction between a white police officer and a regular black citizen, who, you know, the media likes to kind of trump up as, this guy was big and dangerous, and you need six people to take this guy down. Like, this is, but Eric Garner, like Jon Stewart in Daily Show mentions, like, it's a very conflicted message, right? Because he's a gigantic guy, but he also has asthma, and he's a very fragile guy. It's like, oh, so it's not the chokehold or kind of the, you know, the actions of the police that killed him. And no, it was his obesity, it was his asthma and whatnot, and he's just a very fragile being, but at the same time, he's this gigantic, dangerous monster. Like, what the fuck? Like, what? I don't even know. But it's amazing to see kind of the student organizations come, and people in New York City gathering and organizing, and that's been really kind of amazing to see. A couple of my colleagues in some of my classes have gone out there on the streets. I don't think any of them gotten arrested, at least not in NYU, but some of the Columbia students have gotten arrested for being part of it, you know, which raises, I don't know, it's, like I said, it's a very emotional topic, and it's, I don't really know how to talk about this in a coherent manner right now. I just wanted to say something, you know, and I do want to say it's just kind of the organizing going on, I think, is really cool. The conversations are happening, and that's a good start. I think it's, at least we have conversations happening, and we are doing kind of things that are just more solidarity movements, and protests are kind of just, it's been kind of the way that it's been done is really the hands up, don't shoot. A lot of chanting about that, which I think is really powerful, and die-ins. So people will go to a space. So this Monday, this upcoming Monday at Bob's Library, which is NYU's library, and some NYU students are very upset about this. Like, it's finals week. We're in the library to study and to write our final papers. Like, it's finals week. You guys are gonna come to the Bob's Library and protest, like, what, you know, and it's like, why can't you do it somewhere else, like the Washington Square Park, where you're not going to bother anyone, which is an interesting sentiment, and I understand the kind of inconvenience of protesting in Bob's Library for about 10 minutes will do. What they plan to do is just kind of lie out there on the space of Bob's Library and pretend that they're dead for 10 minutes, and it will disrupt traffic in NYU. People, like, you know, people walking around an NYU library to study will have it will be inconvenient. That's the simple truth. It will be inconvenient. It will be disruptive. But I feel like isn't that the point of a protest? I don't know. It's not the entire day. It's just for 10 minutes. But it's kind of, it really is inspiring just to see these kind of organizing movements happen. And of course that begs a question to a lot of people, like, what's the point? You know, what are you guys trying to achieve? And in protest movements or in organizing movements, I think that is a harder question to answer in the short run, you know, but it is, we're really talking about the broader message here. Black lives matter. You know, there is racism inherent within our American system. And it's a criminalization of poverty, and it's criminalization of black people and Hispanic people, you know, darker skinned people who live in this country. And there is this humongous divide now in this country where some people don't even realize this is what's going on, and some people don't want to admit, you know, they're just, so it's like a really huge divide. There's been some kind of even academic reports that says, you know, the inequality that is now inherent between white people and people of color is worse right now in America than it was during the apartheid age of South Africa. So that's just, you know, so much worse, like multiple times worse. So how did this happen? What's going on? You know, how is racism so subversive, so beneath our consciousness? You know, you don't, within our system, people don't have to have, like, intentional racist attitude for it to disproportionately and discriminately affect people of color, which that's another topic for a different video. And I'm thinking to do more videos on those kind of things, because a lot of us don't get it. And, you know, I have to say that I don't quite fully understand it as well, but it's the kind of discourses that are happening is to me disappointing, and I kind of want to start more going towards that route. So definitely expect more videos to there be that. I'm busy with my finals too, and also being more involved in student events and things like that. So while I'm engaged with that, you know, I just wanted to put one video out there, at least this one, talking about this kind of movement and this conversation that's happening around in situations that you know, Eric Garner's tragedy just reminds us so fully. They happen. They're not, you know, these situations do happen where a police officer encounters an unarmed black American citizen, and in the interaction, you know, whether they, you know, did something that was illegal or not is kind of beyond the point, you know, because this is the interaction. The police tries to arrest the person. Sometimes they say, oh, don't arrest me. Sometimes they have no chance but to agree. And you know, whatever ends up happening is that the person ends up dead, the black person. So there are situations like that happening. And why does this happen? How does this happen? And beyond that, the outrage is not even how does this happen, but what is our response to that? I think that's why the protesters and the organized community organizers and advocates are so, like, angry, because the response is nothing. Well, the response is actually the person who filmed the arrest happening. He's the person who got indicted, and he's the person that's going to be on trial for guilty. I don't know what they're charged with. Disrupting police activity. I don't even know. But it is maddening. It's pretty crazy. But that's what it's all about. And really want to say, like, my heart goes out to people who are out there inconveniencing a lot of people, but doing it for the cause, for the movement of bringing this to awareness and trying to make a change where this is what we have right now is not acceptable. The status quo is not, it's not cool. It's not acceptable. And we do have a racist, systematically racist status quo. We gotta change that. And so that's what this kind of movement is about. It's amazing to be in a city where that's kind of happening. Let's see what happens. I'll make more videos about this, I swear. But I'll end it here for now. Feel free to add in your comments, questions, whatever, into the comment section. Keep it civil, though. You know, as always, try not to name call. Try not to attack, insult. But, anyway, if you guys enjoyed, cheers.